Why the decline? America, I think it's because you know something is wrong. When somebody tries to rush you, that's when you need to slow down. I also think you're seeing enough things now that that concern you, but you don't know how to put them all together. I'm going to try to put a few things together tonight and then over the next few days, but I'm telling you. You know, I feel like, you ever see those movies where they say, I gave a note to my attorney, and if I'm found dead, open the note. I kind of feel like you're my attorney. If I show up, you know, in Thailand, dead from autoerotic asphyxiation, don't believe it.
Your experience being brought up in this Illuminati environment, were you ever told anything about where these reptilians came from, and what is the history of it all?
I was made to learn through Mothers of Darkness, which is a certain aspect of the organization, because that was an early, early part of my training, the history of what was the Illuminati on this planet. And what I learned was that the Aryans originally were from Mars, and the reptilians came to that planet to, they came from another place, they came to that planet. They came to rule because they wanted to mix, so they said, with that race. And, but they became the overlords. And the Martians or Aryans were seeking to escape from it, they went to the moon and then were there attacked, and they then went to Earth and established culture here on Earth approximately 6,000 years ago.
There is a theory that the origins of civilization lie at the bottom of the ocean. That there was once a great kingdom called Atlantis, home to an advanced and sophisticated society. The story goes that it perished in a flood around 12,000 years ago. But a few survivors escaped in ships and brought civilization to the primitive peoples around the world.
Barbarian, your end is near. In times of crisis, the ancient wizards of Atlantis used this horn of summoning to gather their people from distant lands. No one of Atlantean blood can resist its call. And since Conan and his Sumerian clansmen are the last descendants of Atlantis, when the horn sounds, they must come.
And at that point in time, they were doing well, and they were mixing with the indigenous population of this earth they were getting along with. And then about 4,000 years ago, the Aryan or the reptilians arrived here and again began to take over, and they instilled themselves in different places, underground in the earth, and also this one part of them, the ruling part, took over and became involved in the politics and in the religion, and started controlling through these means at that point in time, and using the gods and deities that were believed in on this planet, started infiltrating into that and becoming that.
ya, Watto! Ukaskluma! Untul na horti kleptun! Kaskundik apakalon! Uransetun! Donankunskon! Kebi jukate!
Things started, blood rituals started happening, and since that time, that is the way that it has been. And presently, they claim to come from the Merovingian bloodline. They are all of the, there are 13 bloodlines in Europe that all of what are called royalty are developed from or come from. And they include the Aryans in this, and there's been a big push in this century. For example, when Nazis came into power, the fascists, talking about the purity of being pure and staying, the Aryan bloodline staying pure, and what it actually is all about is keeping the blue-eyed, blonde or light red-haired people, the bloodlines pure, because it is more powerful. And what is in that blood for these reptilians is more powerful, and they need that. And when you start mixing it with people that were indigenous to this earth, then it is not as powerful. It has nothing to do with someone skin color or nationality. It has to do with the keeping the bloodline pure for their use.
The Nazis sterilized over 50,000 unfit Germans, which caused an American eugenicist to complain, quote, "The Germans are beating us at our own game." The Nazi eugenic idea evolved naturally into the eventual Holocaust. And
now here is what the President of the United States has told us today.
The rumor that's been circulating a lot lately is this idea that somehow the House of Representatives voted for death panels that will basically pull the plug on grandma because we've decided that it's too expensive to let her live anymore. The intention of the members of Congress was to give people more information so that they could handle issues of end-of-life care when they're ready, on their own terms. It wasn't forcing anybody to do anything.
I don't believe that this is a matter that is appropriate for laughter or for jokes. I want you to clearly understand that I don't think he wants to kill your grandmother or unplug your grandmother. It would be truly an evil person that would do that. However, what happened in Germany was they couldn't afford health care for all. You see, they had devalued their mark, our dollar. They had devalued it so much because the government just started to print money. Does that sound familiar? It has only been done a few times in the world's history, and it has never ended any other different way than it did in the Weimar Republic. America, I ask you to take a good, long, hard look at what's going on today. You must ask with boldness, could our economy, the way we are currently spending and printing at will, possibly go into some sort of emergency situation? Could it collapse? Is it possible? Is it possible that our debt is so high that we can't pay it back, or we have to make tough decisions and possibly ration health care? The answer, everyone will tell you, is yes.
Mentally flawed, thus creating the otherwise contradictory systemic anomaly that, if left unchecked, might threaten the system itself. Ergo, those that refuse the program, while a minority, if unchecked, would constitute an escalating probability of disaster.
This is about Zion.
You are here because Zion is about to be destroyed. Its every living inhabitant terminated, its entire existence eradicated.
Bullshit.
Bullshit.
Denial is the most predictable of all human responses. But rest assured, this will be the sixth time we have destroyed it. And we have become exceedingly efficient at it.